Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by the Excel Pro Weekly Newsletter, published by CFO and written by me. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1516, MAXIF. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Here is today's question. Today's question is, we have a bunch of products listed here in column A and the order date. I want to find the last order date for each product. And I can't guarantee that the products are going to be sorted by latest to earliest, earliest to latest. If it was latest to earliest, boy, that'd be easy. It'd just be a simple VLOOKUP, but can't guarantee that. Now, the old DMAX function would do this, but I'm going to try and do it a different way here. I'm going to ask for equal if. Go look through all of these product names over here in column A. I'll press F4. If that is equal to this product, then I want the date, the corresponding date from column B. I'll press F4 there. Otherwise, I want a 0. Now, this is going to work because I'm looking for the max. If I was looking for the min, then instead of a 0 there, I'd want to put a really large number. All right, now this is going to return an array of answers. In this case, I have 18 rows. You can't see down to row 19, but I have 18 rows of data, so it's going to return 18 answers. And what I need to do is get the max from that. So the max becomes the wrapper function. W-R-A-P-P-E-R, the wrapper function. And of course, we have to hold down Ctrl and Shift and press Enter in order to get that answer. Now, hey, we recognize this. Anytime you get an answer in the 40,000 range, 37,000, 43, somewhere in that range, and you're expecting a date, it's the right answer in the wrong format. So we go through and change that, copy it down, and now for each product, we will see the latest order. Now, let's just test this. I'm going to come here to product B, and I'm going to put in a order date far in the future, like 1/1/2013. And sure enough, it is pulling it there. Could we do this with DMAX? We could, but we'd have to have a separate criteria range for each of the products. So this is a little bit better. While it's more confusing, a lot of people aren't familiar with the array formulas. It gets it all done in a single formula. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.